Here's Brady Tkachuk. He had a goal and three assists. His brother Matthew tried to set him up. Three goals and two assists, and now he has his fourth. They're starting to warm up the Honda Pilot Trail Sport for the MVP if Matthew Tkachuk can keep this going. As you would expect.
He's so good from the tops of the circles down, but really even in closer. He's got quick hands. He's not going to win a lot of races, but he's got quick feet. Look how he uses the reach to spread it around.
Mitch Marner had three assists in the semifinals. Here's Larkin in along. Slid off his stick.
Kaprizov had no idea that he passed it to Dylan Larkin. He thought he was on his team.
Lost the puck. He tried a little short-sider. It wouldn't go in. Pasternak. Tarasenko with three assists in the semifinal. Here's Pasternak in alone on Saros. Played a lot of golf here, we're told, the last couple of days. Seth Jones to the backhand and a beautiful stop by Ullmark. Matthew shot it wide. Atlantic is two number 16s, Marner the other. Marner thought he might play with Matthew Tkachuk, who's denied. Not the oldest goalie to make his All-Star debut. 29 years old. You remember last year, Cam Talbot was 34 in his first All-Star game. There have been others older than that. Long hit ahead. Here's McKinnon. Nathan McKinnon did not score.
Oh, I thought that went in.
Yeah, I think a lot of folks in the crowd did too. Here comes the quick counter. Marner down low for the goal. Nikita Kucherov, his second of the day.
And here's the goal moments later. Nikita Kucherov is going to play a little give and go with Mitch Marner. He goes to the net, chips it up over Saros, and an early 2-0 Atlantic lead.
23 years old, native Californian. 13 American-born players here today. Here comes another, Larkin. To the forehand, and he scores. Well, on another day, Dylan Larkin would be an MVP candidate.
Near the end of the shift, the turnover, and then Larkin's going to get out ahead. Marner lays it out for him, and now Larkin gets inside of Morrissey. Perfect shot. Saros can't get the blocker over to stop this, and it's 3-0 Atlantic.
1929-30, Tiny Thompson of Boston. Got the 25 wins in 29 decisions. Franchise record, 47 goals last year for the Wild. Kaprizov is 27. Another hard worker. Marner. And he sets up another goal by Dylan Larkin, who says, don't hand the keys to that Honda Pilot Trail Sport to Matthew Tkachuk just yet.
Larkin's got all kinds of time to shoot this and squeaks it through the top of the pads of Connor Hellebuck. As Hellebuck squared up, it's like a practice drill, and oh man, there's just almost no room for the puck to go through, and the Red Wings captain gets another one.
For the Red Wings, of any player born in the state of Michigan. Mitch Marner, with about 50 of his family and friends in this building to watch it. Here's McKinnon nearly midway through the second half, and a goal for Mikko Rantanen.
Mikko Rantanen takes the pass from McKinnon. The Avs players combine.
For the Central, they get a great chance down low. But McKinnon elected to pass off to Makar. Here's Pasternak. He scores!
You've got all kinds of time. Pick your shot, and when you've got that release, you're not going to miss very often. Connor Hellebuck's trying to be really patient. Oh, the same place that the Larkin shot beat him, at the top of the pads.
Nice play by Josh Morrissey to poke it away. In his first All-Star game. said he gives Rick Bowness a lot of credit for his improvement. And he just was on ice for a goal.
Yeah,
by set up, Robertson.
Yeah, beautiful finish by Jason Robertson. 43 assists on the season. Just behind Erik Karlsson, an assist by defenseman. And he lays this across to Robertson. 33 goals. Man, Robertson had an 18-game point streak. 21 goals in those 18 games earlier in the year. Look at that pass. Flat. Right on the tape and a great finish. And
Robertson on the long point streak. And Morrissey as well. He had an 11-game point streak back in December. There's the response at the other end. Dylan Larkin. Maybe they can cut the car in half. Just 7 seconds after the Robertson goal, his first point of the day.
Right off the draw, Larkin stays with it, kicks it up, scrambles it through. Deep five hole. 3 goals for Dylan Larkin here in the final. And Atlantic is put this away, 6-2.
Another five hole. So Larkin a hat trick. In the last game, each team had a hat trick. Johnny Gaudreau and Matthew Tkachuk. First time that had happened in a game. They want to just keep on scoring all the way to the buzzer. That's Clayton Keller.
All alone, he's going to one-hand this through the legs of Vasilevskiy with the little deke, just kind of shovels it.
He was having a magnificent year. Yeah, it was so gruesome, you just wondered if it would damage him going forward, but he looks like the same guy who was terrific last year.
Oh, we got a penalty shot.
Why not have a little extra fun here?
Here's the penalty. Seth Jones gets called for the hook there.
Last penalty shot in an All-Star game was in the 2019 final. Patrick Kane tripped the player that resulted in a penalty shot for Seth Jones and was unsuccessful.
Oh. Penalty shot just because. And then looking for creative points as well as the goal back behind his feet. And Hellebuck makes the save.
The last player to serve a penalty.
Can we just roll the last 30 seconds? And oh, in the meantime, it's now in our net again.
We mentioned Dahlin earlier. Goals in each of the first 5 games this season. The first defenseman ever to do that in NHL history. MacKinnon adds another to his ledger. First in this game, third of the afternoon.
And MacKinnon, man, he shoots the puck so well on the move. That noted penalty taker, Johnny Gaudreau.
Yeah, Haiti being winner in the past. Final 10 seconds. And another goal. Ripped in by Cale Makar. His first of the day, why not?
Aware there's only 2 halves in this game, right?
Someone might want to explain that just in case.
Makar, after MacKinnon scores.
Well, these Avalanche players out there now get back to business. They're right on the edge in terms of the playoff race out west.